Welcome students, in this video we are going to discuss about the integration of sine function with power and integration of cos function with some power. There are two possibility and maybe even maybe out. So how can we integrate in case of sine power and only cos power? First of all, we are going to take here odd power of sine. When we are having sine raised to power odd number like this. Previously we have done sine cube theta can be integrated with the help of sine 3 theta formula. But we are going to discuss with another method. Make the one power separate in case of odd power. This should be the derivative. Derivative of which function is sine theta, that is cos theta. So we are going to change sine square in the form of cos sine x dx. Now we are going to putting means use of substitution method. Cos x as t is, derivative of cos is minus sine x dx is dt, but we are having only sine x dx, so minus shift on the right hand side, so it become minus dt only. This become 1 minus t square, open the bracket, we get minus dt plus t square dt. By power rule, integration become minus t and become plus t cube by 3 plus c. So overall, using the value of t as cos x, we get the final answer, integration of sine cube x by using substitution method. Another, we are going to take here, cos raised to power may be given 5 odd power. Same method we are going to do, one power separate, other we have to make such that it should be derivative of a function. Derivative of sine function is given by cos function. We are having identity between cos square and sine square. That's why we are changing here. Cos square can be converted into sine by using cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sine square theta. Now we are going to use substitution method. Putting sine x as t, derivative become cos x dx is equal to dt. So this value will become dt here. It become 1 minus t square whole square. It is now like identity a minus b whole square. Expanding it first, we get a square plus b square minus 2ab. Separating them first, dt we are getting first, t raised to power 4 dt. Next 2 t square dt. Integrating we are getting t raised to power 5 by 5 2 t raised to power 3 by 3 plus c, replacing the value of t. That is given by sine x. It becomes sine x raised to power 5. It is given by 2 sine raised to power 3x by 3 plus c. Next type we are having. Now sine and cos are in group like this. Sine raised to power 3x, cos raised to power 4x. Again method, when the power is odd, one power should be separate, remaining should be separate. Cos raised to power 4 separate. Same trick we are going to do. Sine x dx is a derivative of cos. So we are going to put cos x as t. Derivative of cos is given by minus sine x dx as dt. Same, first of all, we are going to change sine square is equal to 1 minus cos square. Sine x dx remains same. Value of sine x dx from here, by shifting minus sign we get minus dt. It is given by 1 minus t square. It become t raised to power 4. If you open the bracket, we get minus t raised to power 4 dt plus t raised to power 6 dt. On integration by power rule, we are getting t raised to power 5 by 5, t raised to power 7 by 7 plus c. Using the value of t, that is given by cos x raised to power 5, cos x raised to power 7 plus c. Maybe the case whenever the powers of both function are same, like this, we are having sine cube x cos cube x. There are two options, we can break any one of them, either sine otherwise cos. Otherwise we can do like this, it is like sine theta cos theta whole cube. So it should be required cube of 2. Might become 2 sine theta cos theta all cube it become overall 2 sine theta cos theta given by sine 2 theta with power over. Same previous method, we can take one power separate, two power separate, changing sin square into cos square, 1 minus cos square 2x with sin 2x dx. We can do without putting method also. By breaking it, we get 1 by 8 integration of sin 2x dx minus 1 by 8 cos square 2x sin 2x dx. As you know, integration of sine is given by minus cos divided by derivative of angle. 8 is already outside. Minus 1 by 8. If you see here, derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta. So we need here minus, shifting this symbol inside. And derivative of angle become 2. So we multiply by 2, divide by 2, balancing it. Now it become, this is a derivative of cos function. Function with derivative in multiply, it is given by power increase by 1 divided by new power. Like this, we can also do the integration of old power of a function. Next, we are going to take here secant raised to power 4x dx. As we know, secant square is the derivative of tangent. So we are taking here 2 power of secant separate and converting balance secant square in tangent form. Secant square is given by 1 plus 10 square theta with secant square. Breaking it, we get first of all secant square x dx plus tangent as a function with having secant square x dx derivative. Integration of secant square is given by tangent x. Here we are having tangent as a function with power 2 whose derivative is in multiply. So according to rule, increase by power 1 divided by new power plus c. Now we are going to take even power of sine function and cos function. Maybe we are having like this, sin square x cos square x, both functions are even, no one is given over. So it is like sin theta cos theta whole square. So we need here 2 sin theta cos theta whole square. So we need here 4, multiply by 4 and divide by 4. Now it can be written as 2 sin theta cos theta whole square, which can be written as sin 2 theta whole square. We know that sin square integration is not possible. So changing it, multiply by 2, divide by 2. 2 sin square theta identity, we know that it is given by 1 minus cos 2 theta. Making it separate, 1 by 8 dx minus 1 by 8 cos 4x dx. Integrating, dx integration is x. Integration of cos is given by sin, divided by derivative of angle is 4 plus c. So like this, we can do even and odd power of sine function and cos function, and even power of secant as well as cosecant. Thank you.